It's the Tax Geek again with more of your taxes oversimplified. Today the question is, what is the standard deduction? From the earliest days of the income tax system, the government has always recognized that at least some of your income should not be taxed. The original amount of this standard deduction was just $3,000. That seems small, but to put it into perspective, that would be over $71,000 in today's money. Taxpayers have always had the choice of taking a standard deduction versus actually adding up the expenses they could deduct, which most people know as itemizing. We'll look at itemized deductions in other videos. Since the 2018 Tax Cuts and Jobs Act doubled the standard deduction and limited what could be itemized, more and more taxpayers are now taking the standard deduction. This has resulted in simpler returns for most taxpayers. The standard deduction is set by tax law and increases every year as the cost of living increases. Of course, the figures in this video are as of 2020 and will increase annually into the future. Your standard deduction is based on these factors: your filing status, your age, whether or not you are blind, and for taxpayers who are dependents of other taxpayers, your earned versus your unearned income. As I have discussed in other videos, there are five filing statuses: single, married filing joint, married filing separate, head of household, and qualified widow. You can learn more about these statuses by clicking on the card above or by clicking the link in the description below. Here are the base standard deductions for each filing status. Since taxpayers who file separately from their spouses must itemize deductions if their spouse is itemized, their effective standard deduction is zero. However, if neither spouse itemizes deductions, their standard deductions are the same as for a single taxpayer. Your age is whatever your age is as of the last day of the year. However, if your birthday is January 1st, you can use your age on your birthday to determine your age for the prior year. For example, if you turn 65 on January 1st, 2021, you are considered to be 65 for all of 2020. If you are over 65, you can add $1,650 to your standard deduction if you are single, head of household, or a qualified widow. If you are married, filing either jointly or separately, you can add $1,300 to the standard deduction for each spouse who is over 65. Blindness is defined as follows: vision worse than 2200 corrected in the better eye, or a field of vision of less than 20 degrees. You must be able to provide a certification of your vision by an ophthalmologist. This is not submitted with the tax return, but is instead provided to the IRS upon request. Blindness adds to your standard deduction in the same way that being over 65 does. If you are single, head of household, or a qualified widow, you add $1,650 to your standard deduction. If you are married, you add $1,300. Here are some quick examples. Bill and Jill are married filing jointly. Bill is over 65, but Jill isn't. Their standard deduction is $24,800 plus $1,300, or $26,100. Ida is head of household and is neither blind nor over 65. Her standard deduction is $18,650. Dan and Don are married but file separately. Don itemizes deductions, so Dan's standard deduction is zero. Jessica is single and under 65, however she is legally blind. Her standard deduction is $12,400 plus $1,650, or $14,050. Calculating the standard deduction for a taxpayer who is the dependent of another taxpayer is a bit more tricky and depends on whether that person's income is earned or unearned. Briefly stated, earned income is generally income from wages and self-employment. All other income is considered to be unearned. You can learn a lot more about earned and unearned income by clicking the link in the description below. The following figures are based on dependents who are under 65 and unmarried. The absolute minimum a dependent taxpayer's standard deduction is $1,100. and the absolute maximum is $12,400. Between these figures, a dependent's standard deduction is their earned income plus $350. So let's see how this works. All these dependents are under age 65 and unmarried. Derek has savings account interest of $125. His standard deduction is $1,100. Eric has wage income of $5,600 plus income of $1,250 from a trust fund. His standard deduction is $5,950, which is $5,600 plus $350. Roberta has wage income of $6,300 and no other income. Her standard deduction is $6,650, which is $6,300 plus $350. And Martha has wage income of $12,250 plus $650 in dividend income. Her standard deduction is $12,400. Dependent taxpayers can also take advantage of the additions to the standard deductions for age and blindness. Of course, there are additional details in determining a taxpayer standard deduction, but these are the ones that apply to most taxpayers. There is more information in the links in the description. If you found this video informative, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more content. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions for future videos, please leave them in the comment space below. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for more of your taxes oversimplified.